Hey everyone, this is Scary Spikes, and welcome to another Star Citizen video. Today, we'll be talking about the brand new Missile Operator mode, but before we get into it, a very special thank you to Bossman71. He's been with us for a short time, but he's been a lot of fun to play with, a really cool guy to hang around with, and he's been very supportive to our community and myself, especially on our Twitch stream, so thank you so very much, Bossman, for being a member of our community and for being a VIP Gold contributor. You can join us on stream Wednesdays and Fridays at 8 p.m. Eastern, of course, and you can also join our amazing Discord community, links for which will be down in the description below. And if you find this video helpful, it would really mean a lot to me if you showed me some love by leaving a like, subscribing if you're new, and ringing that bell so that you don't miss my weekly videos. With that being said, let's get started with this video. One of the important things of being able to utilize Missile Operator mode correctly is to understand how to properly load missiles on your ship and where physically they are respective to other missiles. So let's go ahead and take a look at that very quickly. We'll press F1 to get into the MobiGlass, and second from the left on the bottom here, we can click this little ship icon to take us to the Vehicle Loadout Manager. On the top right-hand corner of the screen, we'll go ahead and click on that and wait for the list to calm down, and then I'm going to go ahead and choose the Freelancer Miz. There it is. All right, and that's going to bring up our ship. Now, you'll notice on the MISC side here, nothing to do with the manufacturer of the ship, by the way. This is the miscellaneous tab. What you'll notice is that all of our missiles are missing, so we're going to have to go ahead and put some missiles on here if we want to go kill some bad guys. I really wish that we could organize this by groups of missiles, or even better, by racks of missiles, so that what I'm about to say will make a lot more sense and would take a lot less time. Also, just being able to equip all would be really nice, so instead of just clicking this, if there was like an equip to all button, if you just want to use the same missile for everything, that would also be really nice. So CAG, if you're listening, that's basically my wish list for Missile Operator Mode version 2. Anyway, I digress. Let's go ahead and load this baby up. So you'll notice one thing that's different from the previous patch is as soon as I make a selection, as you can see here, we've got Thunderbolts, Arresters, and Vipers. I've got quite a bit of the Thunderbolts there, so I'm going to go ahead and choose that. And as soon as we move on to the next slot, we now only have the choice of Thunderbolt. Did my other missiles just disappear? Well, no, and let me show you what I mean. So if we go back here and unequip the Thunderbolt, okay, we've got our choices back. Now, if we go to the second slot here, we've got our choices again. If we click on the Thunderbolt and go back to the first choice, now we are stuck with Thunderbolt. This is not a bug. This is actually intended. And basically what's happening here is, even though you can't see the organization of the different groups of missiles or the missile racks, is that the game is only allowing you to equip one type of missile for each missile rack that you have. So you can be cognizant of that when you're loading your missiles, that you're only going to be able to put X number of missiles onto a rack that are the same type. You will not be able to mix and match missiles. So for example, if we have a missile rack that carries 4 missiles, we will not be able to run 2 Arresters and 2 Thunderbolts, for example. We'll need to fill up that rack with the same kind of missile that we have in all of the other slots in the same rack. And then if we have multiple racks, we can choose different types of missiles for those racks. But within each rack, each missile has to be the same. All right, let's go ahead and finish this up and then head out into space and start practicing on some bad guys so I can show you guys the real fun stuff. Okay, so we're hanging out here in the Freelancer MIS. Of course, you could be hanging out in any ship that you like that has missiles in it. So that's why I really like it. We've got a target here. He hasn't seen us yet. We're going to go ahead and tell you a little bit more about how Missile Operator works. So the first thing that you need to know is that you can be in either seat. So whether you are in the passenger seat there, the co-pilot seat, or the pilot seat, you'll have access to the Missile Operator mode. And just know that you do not have access to your guns when you are in Missile Operator mode. So for example, if we fire there, we see we have some guns. And if we go over to Missile Operator mode, we no longer have our guns. You can do this by pressing the middle mouse button, and you'll see that you have a circle in the middle of your screen. This is how you target and lock your targets. Of course, you still need to press T in order to lock them like we did here. So Alt T to unlock, T to target, and then of course middle mouse button to switch over to the Missile Operator mode. If we zoom in a little bit here, we can see that we have the Arrestor 3, we have a green bar, and we have a number down below, just to the right of the little missile here. And we also have something that says Thunderbolt 3 here. So this is basically just showing you what the missile sort of looks like, or the fact that you're in Missile Operator mode. It'll show you the next missile and the previous missile. So if you have, for example, if you are in a Harbinger where you might have some size 3 missiles, some size 2 missiles, and some size 5 torpedoes, you will be able to see them. But since all we have right now are arresters and thunderbolts, this is why you see that. And if we press the middle mouse button to switch over, you'll now be able to see that we can see the arresters on either sides there. So that's right mouse button again to switch between the first and the second. And basically that will cycle your missiles even if you have more missile types available. And notice we are not locking him at the moment with our missiles. Locking is automated. So as long as you're within the missile's range, which you can find out at Urkel.games, link below, you will be able to lock it and your ship will do so automatically. However, if you are outside or if you are too close to the ship, you may see some red pips that are spread out around the target. That means that you are too close to the target and that you are not able to lock them. That distance is usually about 1,000 meters or so, but it can vary between different types of missiles. So lastly, there are two more controls that I need to tell you about, and the next one is G. The G key, G as in golf, is going to load up multiple missiles, okay, and get those ready in each of your missile racks. Now, ideally, I think from what I understand, CIG has been saying that they don't want to fire any more than one missiles from each given missile rack. So this might change depending on the ship that you're in and how many missile racks you have. I do believe, and correct me if I'm wrong down in the comments, that the Freelancer MIS does have 4 separate racks. Thus, we are able to fire 4 separate missiles. You can go ahead and press G to cycle back to 1, 2, 3, or 4. And if you don't want to lock, you can, there it goes, press the left mouse button to dumbfire missiles as well. Left mouse button is going to be your primary fire button, whether you are locked on or whether you're firing in dumbfire mode, so just keep that in mind. And that's pretty much all of your controls. So to recap, you have your middle mouse button for your missile operator mode. You have your right mouse button to cycle your missiles. You have your G key to select how many missiles you'd like to fire at once. And then you have your left mouse button, which we won't press again because I like to conserve my missiles, to actually fire your missiles. So let's go ahead and approach this target here and see at which distance we are able to start getting the lock-on effect. Now, when you are getting closer to a target and your ship starts locking on, what you're going to start seeing is a number of green pips that are going to be rotating and eventually making a full circle around your target. You can shoot before that circle is completed, but your lock won't be as good and your chances of hitting will also not be as good. If you wait until the pips go all the way around the target and lock in, that's when you know that you have the best chances of actually hitting your target. Obviously, there are still some issues and bugs to be worked out, and hopefully this, with the other changes that I've been talking about before, will be implemented in a future iteration of the missile operator mode. But what we have so far is actually really great and incredibly satisfying. So there we go. You can see that we now have a full missile lock, and we're going to go ahead and press the left mouse button, and that is automatically going to unload all of our missiles at the target. At that point, our missiles will start to replenish or regenerate or start to get ready to be locked again. It does take a few seconds cooldown. As you can see, there is a bar that cools down. And this is, by the way, based on your looking direction. So if you look away, you're going to start losing lock. And if you look at them again, you're going to start getting that lock back. So just make sure that if you are using head tracking or anything like that, that you're constantly looking at your target and keeping them within this little circle here. Now, a lot of you who have played DCS, for example, or any other sort of very realistic flight sim or combat flight sim might understand this with respect to radar-guided missiles. If you have a radar-guided missile, you basically want to have your sort of your targeting reticle there over the target so as to be able to lock and fire the missile. Now, we don't have anything that's as sophisticated necessarily in the game just yet, but we do still have to have that target within the reticle, and we should be able to take them out with missiles. That being said, if you do run out of missiles or you want to fall back on your missiles, or rather on your guns, you can certainly do so by simply switching over to your guns anytime by pressing the middle mouse button. And we've got some missiles coming our way. There we go. Just dodge the missiles. I'm going to go ahead and launch my missile at him again and hopefully do some more damage. But that's basically how you do it, folks. It's very, very simple. Doesn't take too much time. You do have that cooldown timer that you have to consider. Let's see if we can dodge those missiles. All right, there we go. And launching again. And now you can see we're getting those four or those six red reticles there. And that means that we're simply just getting way too close. So let's go ahead and finish off this target and then we'll wrap it up. So that's going to do it, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this look at the new missile operator mode. If you have any questions or comments or want to add some of your own tips about anything that I may have missed, make sure to leave those down in the comment section below. And of course, it would really help me out quite a bit and to help to grow the channel as well. If you enjoyed the video and found it helpful in any way, to leave me a like, make sure to subscribe if you're new, and to ring the bell so that you never miss my weekly videos going forward. Also, make sure to join us on stream Wednesdays and Fridays at 8 p.m. Eastern over on Twitch, and of course our amazing Discord community as well. Both of those links can be found in the description below. Thanks very much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.